Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and again welcome back in our science session. So up till now we have discussed about objects, classification of an object and also we have discussed about the material. Today we are going to see the one very important point from the same lesson, that is what? Sorting materials into group. So today we will discuss about what is mean by matter. Up till now we have seen that different materials are there, from the different materials we are making the objects. But have you think that how that materials are made, from which things that materials are made? So all the things around us are made up of materials. From which things the materials are made? The materials are made from the matter. Okay, the materials are made up from, are made up of matter. So what is mean by matter? Let's see. Anything that occupies space and has mass is matter. Okay, so the anything that occupies space and has mass is called matter. So see here, if we'll do this, then this is the marker. So if I have kept this marker in this day in the air, it has occupied some space and it has some amount of the mass also, okay, and that property or that things is called as what? Matter. So anything that occupies space and which has a mass, then it is called as what? Matter. Next one that we can say, that all this matter, okay, so see, material is made up of matter. What is mean by matter? Anything that occupies space and has mass, then it is called as matter. But how this matter is made? From which things the matter is made? The matter is made up of extremely small particles called atoms. Okay, the matter is made up of extremely small particles, and that small particles are called as atoms. So see here, again we will discuss, objects are made from the material, but materials are made up of from matter. So each and everything which we can see, that all the things are made up of matter. What is mean by matter? Anything that occupies space and has mass, then it is called as what? Matter. But what is mean by matter? How the matter get made? The matter is made up of extremely small particles, and that extremely small particles are called as what? Atoms. And these atoms are too tiny, too small, that is why we cannot see the atoms with our naked eyes. Okay, so to observe the atoms, we have to use the electronic microscope. So the atoms are the very extremely part of any matter. Okay, it is the extremely tiny minute particles which is called as what? Atoms. So if we'll take the example of copper rod or the copper wire, and if you break that copper wire, then it gets short in the size. But if that, again you see here, this is one copper wire. Okay, so I'll make this copper wire into two pieces. Again I have taken this one, again I will make the two pieces, then it get short in the sides, then again I will make it into the small pieces, then again I will make into the small pieces, like that I will cut, and extremely the small particles again we'll get, and that smallest particle of copper is called as what? Atom. Okay, so that is the smallest particle of copper that we can say that what? Atom. So in this way we can say that iron, gold, silver, the smallest particle of all these objects is also called as what? Atom. So let's take the one example. So we know that the water is made up of hydrogen and oxygen, then water is called as what? H2O, that is only what? Water. Okay, so water is made up of hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, water is made from the hydrogen and oxygen, that is what? H2O, that we are calling as what? Water. So this water is made up of two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. Okay, so the water is made up of what? Two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. So in this way, what we can say, that when the two two atoms of hydrogen comes together with the one atom of oxygen, then what we can get? We get the water here. Okay, so here we can say that like this, this is hydrogen, oxygen, hydrogen. Okay, so these two atoms of hydrogen get combines with the one atom, two atoms of hydrogen get combines with the one atom of oxygen, and then it is made up of, then the water can get made. So the water is made up of two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. So the minute or the minute piece, minute particle of the water consists of what? Two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen, and that is the reason it is called as what? Water molecule. It is not called as atom. Why? Because when the two or more than two atoms comes together, then it forms the molecules. Okay, so the molecules of hydrogen consist what? Two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. So we can say the one more example, that is we can say that carbon dioxide, that is what? CO2. Okay, so the carbon dioxide is made from what? Carbon and two atoms of oxygen, one atom of carbon and two atoms of oxygen. When combines together, then it forms the one molecule of carbon dioxide. Okay, so the smallest particle of the carbon dioxide is made up of molecules, which two molecules? That is what? Carbon and atom. The smallest particle of carbon dioxide is nothing but a molecule. Why? Because in that two atoms come together, that is what? Carbon and oxygen. We can say like this, oxygen combines with carbon and oxygen. Okay, CO2. Okay, two atoms of oxygen get combines with one atom of carbon, and then it forms the carbon dioxide. So if we'll take the minute, the smallest particle of carbon dioxide, then what we will get? We'll get, or that minute particle of the carbon dioxide is made up of two atoms of oxygen and one atom of carbon dioxide, and that is the reason we can say that what? Carbon dioxide molecule. So what is in my molecules? When there more than two atoms comes together, then it forms the molecules. And that singular, only one tiny particle, we can call as what? Atom. When the atoms comes together, then it forms the molecules. Okay, you understand here why we are calling it as a water molecule and the carbon dioxide molecules? Because the atoms comes together and then it forms the water. Here also the carbon dioxide and oxygen atoms comes together and it forms the carbon dioxide. So this is water molecule, this is carbon dioxide molecules. Next one, we can say that the substances that is made up of only one type of atom is called an element. So up till now what we have seen, that these molecules are made up of atom, but what? Different types of the atoms. Okay, different types of the atoms. So when the different types of the atoms comes together, then it forms the molecule. Okay, then it forms the molecule. See, here water molecule is there and carbon dioxide molecule example we have seen. So it is very important concept, student, keep in the mind what is meant by atom. Matter is made up of extremely small particles called atoms. When the different atoms comes together, then it forms a molecules. Okay, when the different atoms comes together, then it forms the molecule. Examples we have seen about water and carbon dioxide. Now we'll see that when the atoms of the same types of the atoms comes together, then it forms the element. The substance that is made up of only one type of atom is called an element. So if the substance is made up of only one type of atom, then that substance is called as what? Element. So these elements cannot be broken down into the simpler form by physical and chemical change. So these elements we cannot break by the physical and the chemical change. Very important thing is that most of the element does not exist as an atoms, okay? They cannot stay alone. The atoms cannot stay alone. So they join to each other and they form a molecules, okay? So the atom singular, they cannot exist, they cannot stay alone. So they get joins together and then they forms the molecule. So here we will take the example of hydrogen atom, okay? So here we can take the example of hydrogen. Two molecules of hydrogen atoms comes together to form the hydrogen molecules, okay? So that same type of the hydrogen, see, hydrogen combines together and then it forms the hydrogen molecules, okay? So here we can say that what? Molecules are made up of atoms, okay? When the atoms get combined, then it forms the molecules. But only the thing is that when the same type of the atoms combines, then it forms the elements, okay? Then it forms the element, and these elements we cannot further classify or we cannot further break by using the physical and chemical method. Very important thing, that atoms cannot exist independently, so they join to each other and then they forms the molecules. Here we can say that one more important thing is that a substance that is made up of two or more elements, okay, the substance which is made up of two or more elements combined chemically in fixed proportion is called a compound. So what is meant by the compound? When the substance is get made by using the different elements, by using the one or more elements, but how? In a fixed proportion, in a fixed proportion, then that substance is called as what? Compound. And that new substance is called as what? Compound. Again, I will repeat. A substance that is made up of two or more elements. What is meant by elements? The substance that is made up of only one type of atom. And when the substances are made up of one or more elements combined together, mixed together in a fixed quantity, in a fixed proportion, then it is called as what? Compound. Okay. So there are so many different examples we can get about the compounds. We can say that here water is made from two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. So water is the one type of compound. Carbon dioxide, we can say that carbon dioxide is made up of two atoms of oxygen, one atoms of carbon. So the carbon dioxide is also what? Compound. We can say that common salt is made up of sodium and chlorine. Also we can say that sugar is made up of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. So here what you have to keep in the mind, when the substances are made up of different atoms, when the different types of the atoms comes together, then it forms the compound. While the same type of the atoms comes together, then it forms the elements, okay? So see here, the substance that is made up of two or more elements combined chemically in a fixed proportion is called a compound, okay? So here all these about today, it is the time to tell you goodbye. We will meet in the next video with the next point, and for today, thank you.